Hugh Rodham came with his caddy. Bill Clinton came with his sax. That angry man, Louis Farrakhan, came with his gun and his axe. When the Reverend Jesse Jackson decided to attend with his love child and nanny, and Rudy Giuliani came with his close, close friend, I knew the Bill and Hill show is over, and Washington's gonna shine. At first there was mayhem when Catherine Graham asked everyone over to dine. But now's the time for inclusion, for reaching out, that's just fine. 'Cause at a political party, George W.'s a friend of mine. The Post, the National Enquirer, the Times, the whole tabloid press, the who's who, the A-list, the straight and the gay list all meet at Lynn Cheney's address. She's wrapped the scallops in bacon, she's stuck the shrimp on a stick. Attend a political party to see what makes this town tick. People, people, the American people are watching a love fest erupt. Right-wingers may enter with guys left of center who think the Supreme Court's corrupt. Remember back in the 60s when politics was more fun, when Kennedy, Carter, and Nixon were smarter, Ford, Reagan, and Bush number one. To put it all in perspective, compare the new status quo. A tamer political party, just where did the old times, silver and gold times, where did the good times go?
Learn to sew, learn to cook, learn to read Italian from a book. Don't have a weary look or a wacky look, but the look they're calling the Jackie look. Got to be chic, got to be smart, got to learn a lot about modern art. Wear a pillbox hat, looking mighty cute, and great big buttons on your new suit. Oh, learn to sew, learn to cook, learn to read Italian from a book. It's not a city look or a tacky look, but the simple, elegant Jackie look. If you want to live in a house that's white, got to hold a big reception most every night. Have tiny hips, tiny waist, and best in Oleg Cassini's taste. Got to be busy around the clock, raise the babies like Dr. Spock. Make somebody a darn good wife and be eminently suited to public life. Ooh, learn to sew, learn to cook, learn to read Italian from a book. It's not a sleazy look or a slacky look, but the grand, intelligent Jackie look. Got to keep in touch, can't be out of reach. Got to take a vacation down in Palm Beach. Learn all about the ballet dance, speak the language they speak in France. If you want to be first lady like, got to learn to ride a horse, not a bike. Learn to speak into a mic, you and Jackie can look alike. Ooh, learn to sew, learn to cook, learn to read Portuguese from a book. Be extra careful just how you dress, face of the nation and meet the press. Got to have charm, got to be sweet, got to be a member of the elite. Have lots of cash in the pocketbook, and that's how you get the Jackie. Ooh, learn to sew, learn to cook, learn to read Arabic from a book. Is that a city look or a tacky look? A chemise look or a slacky look? But if you try, you might cracky look just the way you see Jackie. Ooh, how you gonna keep them down in the farm after they've seen Jackie? Well, how?
Mary's planting cabbages, Paul's driving oxen, Charlie is giving the tractor a push, Henry is haying, Sam is surveying, John's building bathrooms out in the bush. Our delegation's doling out rations, inoculations and firewood. We're building nations, new railroad stations, our inclinations to do good. Serve voluntarily, and glory is the great reward we get. For solvent financially is every peace. baking brownies. Jane's leading nature walks. Mel's teaching folk songs on the guitar. Jim's building bridges. He went to heaven. People are equal wherever they are. Zoom, zoom, zoom.
When we came, there were 33 of us. But Agnes drowned in the swamp. And Lucy was bitten by an armadillo. Peg found a serpent underneath her pillow.
Marge was lost in the first monsoon. And Harriet was hit by her own harpoon.
And that left just 28 of us. Just 28 bananas in the bunch.
28 bananas in the bunch.
Took the natives out fishing.
And the natives had him for lunch.
The natives had him.
Dick was caught by a giant ant while out chasing butterflies one day. George was swallowed by a man-eating plant.
And Herbert simply wasted away. And now there are just 13 of us. A little bit depleted though we are.
Zoom, zoom. We won't kick, long as we stick.
Stick, G-O-G-O-G-T-H-E-R.
Rah! Too bad that Mary's got berry. Paul's got pellagra, Jane's got the yaws. Poor little Eva, black water fever, stretches the stomach and weakens the jaws. Hail, oh hail, we'll carry up till the very last rattle is heard. For what's the motto of the Peace Corps? Togetherness indeed, togetherness indeed, togetherness indeed. Last spring, a group of women went to picket for disarmament, protesting to the president. Plans were all made in Chappaqua and Englewood, in Cedarhurst and Maplewood. Manhasset did the best it could to come to their aid. There was Marion from Darien, there was Jerry from Danbury, and Miss Perry from Dobbs Ferry, and the whole second grade. There was Millie from the Meredith, there was Mary Bell from Little Nick. And so we just hollered, what the heck, and joined the parade. We went down to Washington, together on the train. We pulled into Union Station, but it started to rain. As we were marching two by two up Pennsylvania Avenue, until the White House came in view with our banners displayed. Ah, then standing there before us was Myrtle Thompson's niece, saying,
never mind the weather, girls, let's picket for peace.
Hear the second grade in chorus, their voices smooth as silk, singing, please keep your strontium out of our milk. It was thundering, it was pouring, it was anything but boring, as we walked around ignoring the swarms of police. Our sandwiches at 2 p.m. like us were all soaked through by then.
The second grade by 3 p.m. has started to sneeze. Then Adelaide from Levittown
tripped Madeline from Tarrytown, who slipped and landed upside down, which started a spat. With her temper raging uncontrolled, she took Addie in a stranglehold. Then she picked her up and knocked her cold and jumped on her hat. We entered the battle, then they ordered us to stop, arresting poor old Madeline, who had bitten a cop. Which left us all disquieted. You know the reason why it did. The March for Peace had rioted, and that ended that. Then lowering our banners, we hastened our retreat down Pennsylvania Avenue with an air of defeat. We staggered to the station a little after five as we headed for home, much more dead than alive. Arriving in suburbia,
that's when I got pneumonia. It settled in my bronchia.
White Plains has the flu.
And afterwards, though you may scoff,
they took poor Myrtle's larynx off.
The second grade still has a cough.
I have one too.
epidemic hits. Mount Kisco took the brunt of it, with Bedford Hills in front of it. They buried Bernice, ha ha ha.
But we still support our cause, it is imperative, of course it is. That's why we march, because it is so.
Testing will cease if you go to Washington from your community.
Better tell your delegation to take warning from me.
And put your Macintoshes on, their sidewalks there to slosh upon. Make sure you've got galoshes on. We're marching for peace.
Going to be seven little nations till that terrible day. When somebody took the unity from our economic community at the very first opportunity.
De Gaulle? De Gaulle, you're driving us all up the wall. The great common market was founded by you, but couldn't you try to forget Waterloo? You've treated poor England just like an old shoe. It proves, General De Gaulle.
You beat her out of the market, and Europe's united no more. With epithets hurling, you took the pound sterling and trampled it in the
floor. You never liked NATO at all. You turned on your heel with a Trinidad quoi. Said Yankee, go home as you waved au revoir. Très anti-American, n'est-ce pas? Top to bar, General de Gaulle.
You're having relations with China and marching with banners unfurled. You're constantly speaking so Arab, so picking while you're colonizing the world.
You liberated Montreal. Why, feed the Quebec, then you claimed her for France. The Louisiana Purchase was pardonable. You can suck it out of your pumps, those pumps.
This for you, and that for you, and this for your papa.
And bouts of guitar, but just what accounts for the awful far you are. Charlie, my boy, oh Charlie, my boy, you're pining for Paris, Kentucky. You'd annex Versailles, Illinois. You're sly as a fox is, that gold at Fort Knox is the stuff that you'd really enjoy. Ego, we're willing to swap something small. Cementing relations, we'll try it your way.
Leave you back, leave all in Charles' remain.
And Jean Genet, kindly take him away. Delay, Federal de Gaulle. Just let England into the market. Accept a Polaris or two. Put nuclear power up your Eiffel Tower. And we'll be there for
make way
for the young.
C'est la vie.
At 77, your motto must be liberty, equality, senility.
England welcomes you, you free. The Polish you were old and foolish when you just appeared there, interfered there thus, insulted, all your talks were halted, and you grinned, though vaulted, after Poland welcomed you.
So nice to hear that name again, Ladybird. Would you say it again?
Oh, I'd be proud. Ladybird. Dear Mr. Audubon, if he were alive today, dear Mr. Audubon, he would certainly say, Ladybird, you lovely Ladybird, thanks so totally, thanks so much for notoriety to the Audubon Society. You're a bird of paradise. My song of praise is intended to suffice for all the other LBJs like Lindbergh. Your cavalier bird, you should be proud and be proud today. We're flying round from east to west. You've been feathering your nest as a
my arteries growing so thick. Why is my pulse beat failing? Senior citizens, old and gray, down on our arthritic knees, constantly grateful the USA can pay our doctor's fees, we're saying. M for the medicine, E for the enema, D for the dexedrine, I for the iodine, C for the clinic, and A for the ambulance fare. R for the rabies shot, E for the Epsom salts, M for Medicare. In the pink of condition, we thrive in style. Doctor, it's our ambition to stay alive a while. With M for the malady, E, I'm in ecstasy, D with dyspepsia, I influenza, C high cholesterol, A and an allergy rare. R for recovery, E for the elderly, W for Medicare. Feel this hand that's cold and clammy, your beloved old grandmammy wants an itty bitty pity. If your oath is Hippocratic, then your fees are automatic, all decided by committee. Hear this ticker, clicker, quicker, we were richer, we were sicker, now our roles should be reversed. Older folks once caused you trouble, till you learned to charge us double, knowing you'd be reimbursed. By M for the mental test, E for the eye exam, D, it's deplorable, I'm an invalid, C with my cardiac, A, I'm anemic, I swear. R, what's the remedy? E, lost my energy, we need Medicare. Since we live on a pension fixed income too, doctor, mind if we mention the cross we bear is blue. With M for the minimum, E of expenses, with D disability, I my insurance gifts, C lots of coverage, A and assistance, it's true. R, this recipient. E is elated, so doctor, why not you? Give us pills for our ills, then be sure to pad the bills. You'll feel great when you're getting your share. Doctor, stash your cash away, 'cause you'll be old like us someday, and you'll need Medicare.
Said, practice your peep. Oh, someday you may get to Peking. Well, Mama was not far from wrong. I paddled my way to Canton. We're looking at Mom's little guy. Hi. A team in Shanghai. Hi. And dined with Premier Chu and Lai.
Hi.
So what if your son is a hippie? He's gotta be smarter than you. 'Cause Mom, you can bet your sweet nippy, you'll never have dinner with Chu. Quotations from Mao Zedong. Were right on the tip of my tongue. The Mandarin duck was delish. Swish. Mandarin fish, what a dish. Swish. I think that the China was Ming. Ping. This cat got a look at a king. Ping. While sipping my lapsang su chang. Pong. Pong. Ping. Pong. Ping. Pong. When we crossed the bridge to Hong Kong. Pong. I waved as I greeted the throng. Pong. Ping. Pong. Ping. Home, I've been doing the rounds. Pong. I've met Barbara Walters, Hugh Downs. Pong. I played Joey Bishop, who lost. Ping. And I really trumped David Frost. Ping. While teaching Dick Cabot to swing. Ping. 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 Pong. Ping. Pong. Ping. Well, Mama, I'm perfectly certain that you should be stricken with awe. I parted that old bamboo curtain and started the big power thaw. So what if my hair is too long? If my dedication is strong? Then someday, a few years from now, pow, when I'm dining with Chairman Mao, pow, and you'll see the pendulum swing. Just think of the changes I'll bring, because I'll be doing my thing.
I streak the Senate, I streak the House, I streak the FBI. Down Pennsylvania Avenue, I went streaking by. I peeked in a White House window, and who should I see there? But the Reverend Billy Graham praying, saying, you out there, you better cover up, cover up, do the Watergate cover up, cover up, cover up, cover up today. Gerry Ford was having his breakfast. Pat and Trish and Julie were there. I could see by peeking that they'd been streaking, 'cause everybody was bare. I stared at Bebe Rebozo, those Nixons, Edward and Don. You must be chilly, said Reverend Billy. Bebe, put your panties on. You better cover up, cover up, do the Watergate cover up,
cover up, cover up, cover up today.
There was Ronald Ziegler in nothing. There was James St. Clair that I saw. There was Trisha's hubby, all pink and chubby, standing up in the raw. And there was Comeback the nudist. Hey, Herb, I heard Billy shout. You show them plenty at San Clemente. Please don't let it all hang out.
You better cover up, do the Watergate cover up, cover up, cover up, cover up today.
And Rosie Woods was dancing stark naked.
Oh.
She was. General Haig was stripped to the skin. When a trumpet sounded, a voice resounded, and Mr. Nixon walked in. Make one thing perfectly clear now. For my instructions are brief.
As Haig saluted our birthday suited great commander-in-chief.
You better cover up.
Cover up. Do the Watergate cover up. Cover up. Cover up. Cover up today.
So take warning, all of you streakers, when you next appear in the buff. Don't be really silly, a tip from Billy says, enough is enough. Just say a prayer for revival of our dear old GOP. Billy's just proposing you'll be exposing only your philosophy, you sinners.
Cover up, do the Watergate cover up, cover up, cover up. Cover up today!
When this whole impeachment is over, we'll just look back and say, whatever became of what's his name, and where is he today? Goodbye, it's been so nice to know you. Goodbye, till your expletives too.
Peanuts, fried chicken, and free nuts, the very
we've all heard Jimmy discuss the issues. Foreign affairs, domestic affairs, welfare, unemployment. But I think we're going to see that the real issue in this campaign is peanuts. We're voting for peanuts. A person with peanuts who disagrees. Peanuts, you're all going to see nuts. Hot biscuits with peanuts and black eyed peas. Someone from New to the Bible Belt can straighten the Washington scene. He told you when with a magnolia is all it takes to make Washington clean. Round the country people swarm to the best port in a storm. Disposition nice and for agrarian reform, they call him Peanuts. They'll certainly be nuts, peculiar and peanuts from Uncle Sam. Telling by thumping and smelling each ripe watermelon and country ham, he'll be the fellow the Yankee folk will follow through thick and through thin. This planter from Southern Atlanta will guarantee nuts if Jimmy gets in. Help him to win for all those salted, toasted, fresh, hot roasted peanuts when Jimmy gets in.
Lust in my heart, and you're the one who I'm lusting. I'm about to bust in my heart, because I know I can't be trusted. I'll turn to dust in my heart, if all this lust can ever be. I mustn't lust in my heart, lest this lust get the better of me. I've got a list in my heart of all the ones whom I've lusted. All those I've kissed in my heart, if I but knew they'd be disgusted. If I insist in my heart, I'd rather twist in ecstasy. Although I lust for my list, still my list isn't lusting for me. I got better abs. I've got mini pearls. And on my lust list, you will find Miss Lillian. Some 50 million who are my kind of girl. I hate this lust in my heart. Oh, how I try to douse the fire. A knife you thrust in my heart still couldn't cure me of desire. I adjust in my heart and merely leave this lust behind. Doing my best lest this lustless I lost God's effect in my heart. Or on my lustless I've got far from all. I've got Barbara Howard. And on my lust list, I've got Barbara Streisand. And on my lust list, I've got Betty White. Still I can't find the light. Two ribbons sliced is my heart. Oh, it makes me feel so catish. Chopped up and iced is my heart. I feel just like a piece of radish. I've cried, oh Christ, in my heart. This lousy lust will never do. I'll keep this lust till I bust. For the last on my lust is you.
President Carter has recognized the seriousness of the energy crisis and the overwhelming problems facing our nation. In the future, an unless positive action is taken now. Further, he insists that every person must make his individual contribution to conservation, regardless of position, income, or community status, and how. Oh, God, I'm trying to comply. Ours is to conserve the natural resources. Ours is not to reason why. I got into my Volkswagen with my little boy Henry and my little girl Mabel and my wife Henrietta and my big boy George and my teenager Alyssa and my two dogs and a cat and my cello. And we got as far as Dubuque with my little boy Henry and my little girl Mabel and my wife Henrietta and my big boy George and my teenager Alyssa and my two dogs and a cat and my cello. When we got there, we really felt rested, as if we had taken the bus. No gas guzzler for us on our trip out west. President Carter, we're doing our best. I turned off all the electric lights in the kitchen, and I never used an electric can opener or an electric toaster or an air conditioner or an electric grill anymore or anything electric. And I don't waste hot water, and I don't waste gas, and I don't waste, and I even save little bits of string, and I don't use paper napkins, or paper towels, or paper plates, although it sometimes makes life hectic. We believe in your energy program, and we're gonna start saving our fuel. We'll do it for you all, when put to the test. President Carter, we're doing our best. We're not saving any money. And as for this energy program, I wish we were through with it. Though I'm not trying to be funny, I sure as hell can tell you just what I wish you would do with it. So don't ask me any more favors, and I'll pay you all those taxes, even though I don't get my $50 refund, and I can't afford to pay the rent, and I can't afford to move, and every day I get deeper in debt, and I've had my fill. And I don't like this wind-up can opener, and I can't afford to send my kids to college, and even if I could afford to buy a house, I couldn't afford to insulate it. And I'm getting so fed up that pretty soon I'm going to move to Brazil. But to help you avoid a disaster, we'll pay through the nose at the pump and go through a swamp and live in a dump, if that's what you suggest. President Carter, we're doing our best.
Ball. And La Belle Lance of finances. I'm a Rosalind Carter, and if I try harder, someday I may be number one. But hi, diddle, diddle, I'll play second fiddle until I'm second to none. I've heard the discussions we've had with the Russians and worked on our energy plan, and I'm sitting pretty on every committee, just being a help to my man. I stay in the background, some quiet nights. The news I would not interfere, except for the times Jimmy needs my advice. Then I cry, Rosalind's here. I'm a Rosalind Carter, three sons and one daughter. Say, Jimmy can't do it alone, so I'll be in clover until I take over. The power behind. Oh, Jody Powell. Jody Powell, you may tell Miss Lillian that I'm ready to see her now in the green room. And when you finish telling her that, sir, please shut your mouth. The power behind the throne.
I want a Secret Service man for Christmas. I want my own designer for the fall. I won't be glad till I'm on the cover of Time and have my own inauguration ball. I want a bowling alley in my house, and to make my dearest wishes all come true, I want my daddy to be president, just like you. I want to ride a limousine to school. A puppy dog named Grips, who walks and stands and sits. I want to swim in my own heated pool. I want to make a hit with Walter Mondale and to walk down Pennsylvania Avenue. Oh, gosh, I want my daddy to be president, just like you. Roosevelt Longworth was Teddy's little girl. She wore an Alice blue gown. And Linda Bird and Lucy Baines had dozens of electric trains. And Julie and Trish had tiny dolls and fish. But I want my own ex-convict. And while I hold my breath, she'll tuck me in and tell me tales to scare me half to death. Christmas. I want to take a ride on Air Force One. I know I'd like a lot, a presidential yacht, and summers at Camp David would be fun. I changed the law to say there'd be no homework, and the children could stay up till one or two. That's why I want my daddy to be president, just like you.
Cleopatra, Sheba, both extravagant queens, had nothing on Imelda of the Philippines. When lifestyles of the rich and famous came to call, she said,
"I am the richest and most famous of all."
Imelda had 6,000 shoes. The papers came out with the news.
I kissed them goodbye, went off to Hawaii, and left behind all of my shoes.
Imelda had handbags and slacks, designer gowns hanging on racks.
Contra.
gone. You have the papers gone. The things that Ollie said and did already carried on. Have they been shredded by a beautiful girl? The one who's headed for a wonderful world. National security, you acted as a pawn. They tried to pin the goods on Rosemary Woods. Those days have come and gone. And who's the star of Iran's scam?
Just begun. I've been reciting doctored memos I've known. Soon I'll be writing some memos of my own. Right. And I've heard so much hype about a secretary who they say can't even type.
Loaded with sex appeal, the Senate thought. The toast of Iran's scam.
Me.
Close down the White House law. A moving contract in six figures recently was drawn. A mini series that we're anxious to see. And lots of queries. Lawyer spots on TV.
I tell you frankly that I'm planning to accept them all. I'm gonna air my views on the national news. Advise the Pentagon.
For who's the queen of Iran?
Wipe up Gerry Hart.
At the White
My makeup is merry when I wipe off each tear. We're convinced they were nuts. Drinks I got with those sluts. Now Jimmy lost the pulpit.
And Gerry lost the race.
And Jim lost a big weekly check.
Alaska to clean oil spills offshore. Didn't act namby-pamby like he used to before. Whip! No more!
Since he first faced the camera and he said, read my lips, and he crossed Boston Harbor to sail other ships, then defended and quailed for all those bloopers and slips.
Whip! No more!
Was he who assisted at the birth of Millie's pops and championed human rights?
Facing hostile hostage warnings on sticky White House mornings
and chilly cannon book.
Taxes for the country he runs.
One Republican daughter,
four Republican sons.
No, he banned sales to China of all weapons and guns.
Whip! No more!
When he vetoed a wage hike,
cause it made him so sore,
and condemned Chinese soldiers
for the blood and the gore.
Just watch George pitching horseshoes.
He racks up quite a score.
Whips no more.
He befriended John Tower,
though he knew John would fail.
People blamed Ollie North.
He wouldn't send him to jail. Who'd believe once this bold ex-preppy wasp went to jail?
Whips no more.
'Twas he who insisted he could wipe out crime and drugs, pollution across the land.
Yet till he picked Johnson, knew just who knew we knew you knew. His head was hidden in the sand, the sand. But he sure changed his image and he's been turning tough. Why not ask Maggie Thatcher? Didn't he treat her rough? For a point came when Barbara said,
enough is enough.
Ginger, peachy, reading Kafka and Nietzsche.
Moreland Fitzwater.
Robert Mossbacher.
Margaret Tutwiler.
Three who helped to make George Bush look great. Marlon Fitzwater.
Robert Mossbacher.
Margaret Tutwiler.
Representing press, commerce, and state. Each time Bush confronted a menial blitz, he often as not just relied on their wits and said, my tongue's twisted, if custom permits, I'll just call them Moss, Tut, and Fitz.
Marlon Fitzwater.
Robert Mossbacher.
Margaret Tutwiler.
A completely dependable crew.
Orrin Hatch.
Arlen Specter.
Red Scowcroft.
We're completely dependable too. He found them invariably not at a loss. They never were sassy, they never were cross. So they were referred to by George Bush, their boss, as Orr, Arbren, Tut, Fitz, and Moss. And one day he loses Sununu, who suddenly just up and quits. Though only a few knew the fate of Sununu, those who knew were Moss, Tut, and Fitz.
Marlon Fitzwater.
Robert Mossbacher.
Margaret Tutwiler.
Is a trio that's joined at the hip.
Lawrence Eagleburger.
Charles Eichelberger.
Newt Gingrich.
They all once made a terrible slip. They tried to take over, no ifs, ands, or buts. They wanted those jobs, Mosses, Fitzes, and Tuts. So President Bush simply gave them the boot. Neither Orr, nor Brent, Eagle, Eichel, or Newt could ever replace such top Washington hits as those Bush all-time favorites, Moss, Tut, and Fitz.
Get up every morning, punch the time clock 9 to 5. But nobody in the office even knows that I'm alive. I hang around the water cooler, drowning all the livelong day. A little sexual harassment in the workplace never seems to come my way. Just the secretary, sitting right there by the boss. Tried attracting her attention, but I just don't come across. She's stuffing papers in the shredder, Xerox until I turn blue. A little sexual harassment in the workplace, nobody's wanting to do. It's so taxing, out there faxing, get no winks and no stares. Yearn for pinching, high-tech lynching. Hell, who knows and who cares? Some believed in Clarence Thomas, some believed Anita Hill. But nobody has believed me, and I know they never will. I tried to be enticing, I'm forever out of the wonder how it could be, cause baby, nothing ever happens to me.
Go off your Christoph Beverly Hills, give us for that haircut of bills. Give an essential presidential using my scissor skills. Shearing, shaking, snip, 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 snip. Summoned during Bill's West Coast trip. For those who clamor for Arkansas glamour, 90210's my sit. Rendezvous on the tarmac. My butter's gel and shampoo. And carefully quaffed till he went aloft, all tea styled and blow dried anew. Dreaming of his energy tank. controllers about that two-hour delay. The end of, I fear, my brilliant career, but the scandal just blew it away. Air Force One as a spa. Coiffure by Christoph, coiffure by Christoph. Now $400, au revoir. Coiffure by Christoph, c'est moi.
Impeachment, what a drag. Self-pity, not my bag. Beyond the beltway, I had to roam. It takes a village to provide a new home. Before I bought a house in Chappaqua, couldn't find it on the map, Chappaqua. It was selected to get me elected. And then I went back down to Washington and bought me another one on Embassy Row there for a bundle of dough there, plus a New York pied-à-terre in Bill's Harlem Tower. Now he's commuting from there in less than an hour to where I wield the power. Our secret hideout out in Chappaqua, sequestered in Chappaqua, with lots of guest rooms to fill, a private study for Hill, and a doghouse for Bill. If life should catch you in a Chappaqua, you must move to Chappaqua, suburban seclusion, without an intrusion. And also get a place in Washington, in case you decide to run. Make sure it's the right house, on the road to the White House. It's like a furniture mart, each time I accrue room. Collecting objects of art, I pinch from a blue room, just to furnish each new room. I'll spend the next few years in Chappaqua, in limbo in Chappaqua, slyly concocting a plan to run for president, and then I'll make Bill my first man.
This looks like our kind of party. Al Sharpton's brought Linda Tripp. I see Gary Bowers with Jennifer Flowers. They're dunking their chips in the dip. Across the board invitations, Dick Cheney's with Denise Rich. Another political party proceeding without a hitch. Strom Thurmond came with his nurses. James Carville came with his spouse. They're watching Ralph Nader along with Ruth Bader do cartwheels all over the house. Al Greenspan's leading the trio. Ben Bradley's at the buffet. All kinds of political people are dancing the night away. Party, party, a bipartisan party. Al Gore, Condi Rice, Kenneth Starr. The whole thing's unrace-based, as long as you're faith-based, no matter which faith-based you are. So ring that Washington doorbell and have a glorious night. With Jeb Popilora imbued with an aura that Texans can only do right. When honored guest Catherine Harris is seated by Sally Quinn, then Washington's latest insiders are gonna include you, ply you with food you, who never wooed you, and often booed you, and misconstrued you, gonna include